Dear students, today we will see next concept in e-commerce, that is certificate-based authentication. What is certificate-based authentication? It is one type of digital certificate or digital signature to identify a user. And as you know, digital signature is a nowadays common concept to identify the user. And here, it is often deployed to coordinate with the traditional methods such as username and password. So commonly the username and password, what happens? Anybody can enter username and password on the behalf of user. But in the digital signature, the personal interference is required to identify the or to take the advantage of documents. Certificate based authentication is that, unlike some solution that only work for users such as biometrics and one time passwords OTP, the same solution can be used for all endpoints, that is users, machine, devices in and even the growing internet. Why is certificate based authentication is used? Easy of deployment and ongoing management. Most certificate-based solutions today come with cloud-based management platform that makes it easy for administrator to issue certificates to new employees and the renew certificates and revoke certificates when an employee leaves the organization. And commonly you can see nowadays there is a Aadhaar-based authentication. Aadhaar-based authentication, what happens? When the people or maybe the organizations want to check the identification of user, then it will connect it to Aadhaar-based server on the cloud and it will take the signature, digital signature identification information from the Aadhaar-based server. And that is called as cloud-based management platforms. Solutions that integrate with Active Directory can make the enrollment and issuance process even easier by enabling auto-enrollment and silent installations. Unlike some authentication methods like biometrics or OTP tokens, there is no additional hardware needed. That is the another advantage. Additional hardwares are not needed since it is a e-authentication. Certificates are stored locally on the machine or device. This not only saves on costs but can also alleviate management pains around distributing, replacing and revoking tokens. Nowadays you can see, so there are the concept of cookies in your laptops or in desktop, even in the mobile. And these cookies will store the tokens or the digital signatures in your laptops or computers. By that you can take the advantage. Again, the resubmitting or the re-authentication is not necessary every time. That only they have given here. Certificates are stored locally on the machine or device. This not only saves on cost but can also alleviate management pains around distributing, replacing and revoking tokens. User friendly. There is always a trade-off between increasing security and the cost involved and burden on end users. Most people don't think of it, but using certificate is very easy for end user. After the certificate is installed, there is nothing further to be done. Additionally, most enterprise solutions already supported certificate-based authentication. Leverage existing access control policies. You can also easily leverage existing group policies and permissions to control which users and machine can access different applications and networks. This way you can ensure only privileged users can access sensitive or critical operations. Okay, leverage existing access control policies. Whatever the control policies are there for the read and write the information, the same can be implemented for these operations. but along with digital signatures. Mutual authentication. Another benefit of using certificate is that it allows for mutual authentication, meaning both parties involved in a communication are identifying themselves, whether that communication is from a user to user or user to machine or machine to machine. For example, a client must prove his identity to a company on intranet, and the internet must prove his identity to the client before a connection can be made. Extending to external users, certificates are also easy to roll out to users outside of your organization. Example, partners, contractors, even freelancers who may need to access your network. They won't need additional software on their local machine, and the ease of use means you won't need to provide much additional training. What does web server security mean? There is another concept called web server security. This is the last concept in the first chapter. Web server security refers to the tools and technologies and process that enable information security. Web server security refers to the tools, technologies, and the processes that we will use on the web server to secure the information which is on the server. This broad term encompasses all processes that ensure that a working internet server operates under a security policy. Web server security is the security of any server that is deployed on a worldwide web domain or the internet. It is implemented through several methods and in layers, typically including the base operation system, that is operating system, security layer, hosted application security layer, and network security layer. That means it depends upon the TCP/IP architecture. These layers are used in the web server security. And this OS security, which access to authorized users only, operates on a web server critical components and services. Application layer security ensures control over the content and services hosted on the web server. Network security provides protection against internet-based security exploits, viruses, and attacks. Okay, so application layer ensures control over the content and services hosted on the web server, and the network layer, so network layer protocol will check for the security problems or maybe virus attacks, etc. Secure socket layer, SSL certificates, HTTP secure protocol, and firewall are several tools and technologies used to implement web server security. Okay, SSL certificates, HTTP secure protocol, as you know, HTTPS, and firewall. When some people will provide with antivirus, there will be a firewall concept. And in the firewall, what happens? If anything comes from the outside, it will check and it will give the permission to that file or information. Without checking the information, with the security definition, it will not allow the outside information. That concept we will call it as a firewall concept. Web server security is crucial, is the most important task for any organization that has a web server. So one must take some necessary actions to enhance web server security. Below is list of tasks one should track when securing a web server. Okay, when we are maintaining web server security or when we are going for web server security, it is an important concept. There may be several information, maybe related to organization or maybe related to persons, and that you have to secure in a proper order or maybe by taking different security measures. So what are those things. First one, take away unnecessary services. When services keep running on a operating system, ports can be often left open. These open doors are sensitive to malicious users to misuse. Switch off all unnecessary services and disable them. Turning off unwanted services, it also gives an extra raise to the performance of the server. Okay, take away unnecessary services. Don't install unnecessary apps or applications on the devices. Remote access. It is important to be sure that remote accesses are secured properly. This by using encryption protocols. A good security practice is using security tokens and other single sign-on equipment and software. Even nowadays, you can see in banks, there will be a sign-on equipment and it will check if the computer is left for maybe 1 or 2 minutes. Once again, he has to give the finger touch, and that type of concept called as remote access security. Permissions and privileges. A network service and file permissions play a vital role in web server security. When a web server engine is compromised, there is a possibility that any user can get access and they can carry out any task inside the server. Therefore, it is very important to always assign the least amount of privileges, such as web server software. Okay, so the privileges means permissions. There may be read, write, alteration, deletion, different privileges which are available even on the network operating system, and those privileges you have to use in a proper way to manage the network information on the server. Monitor and audit the server. Web server login should be stored in a separate area. This way, website access, network services, database server, and operating system logs can be monitored frequently, making the audit easier. Monitor and audit the server. So, if any person uses username and password, or he logins the server, then we have to record those information in a separate file. Then it will be very easy to audit the users. Separate development, testing, production environment. All applications can easily be found by unwanted users. So, development and testing should always be done on server isolated from the internet. This can help prevent intrusive behavior and other complications. Use security tools provided with web server software. Microsoft has released a number of tools to help administrators secure IIS server installation. As a matter of fact, configuring such tools is a slow process and can be time consuming. Also, with custom web applications, they add an extra amount of security, and with this, there will be a peace of mind. That means we have to take the advantage of security controls or security tools which are there in the operating system. Okay, maybe operating system is a base for the working. You can take the advantage of it. In every operating system, there will be a different security measures. Maybe in the Microsoft, there is a depender. Okay, and if you activate the depender, it will do the task of firewall. Those type of tools we can use in the web server. Install all security patches on time. A patch software does not mean your server is secure. Okay, and it is very crucial to update your operating system. Don't use the patch software. Patch software means illegal software, or maybe the software with cracks. We'll call it as a patch software. And in the patches, what happens? There will be a trojans given by the hackers. By that, they will track the information, or they will track the work of the user on the web server. So that's why when you are using some secured information, don't use the patch softwares. Stay informed. Finally, it is very important to stay tuned and learn about new attacks and update tools. Stay informed by reading security related news and magazines and also with course related to the field. Always you have to interact with the internet to find out the new information on security. That is, stay informed. So these are the concepts related to web server securities, and it completes our first chapter. And in the next chapter, I'll start with web designing concepts. So that is your another chapter. So after the first chapter, I'll take that one. It may be helpful for you to do the web designing. Thank you. God bless you.